Welcome to the fastest stop in town. Today on the sector's band top mem, we are going to begin on the bottom of Lamed Tes Amid Beis by the Mishnah. Mishnah says, Mishahayu Peirosav Be'ir Acheres. Let's say a person has fruits that they obviously want to get their hands on, but they are now currently in a different city. Be'ir Bubnei Osair Lahavi Etzlo Mepeirosav. And the people from that area are willing to be able to bring his fruits over. Lo yobulo. It's not allowed, says Rashi. They cannot bring from his fruits. Hoel behu lo erev lahem l'sham. He did not make an erev, so he can't go there. Dahakol karagli habalim. And therefore the fruits are connected to that person. And therefore someone else cannot bring them for you because you yourself cannot get to them. So therefore, unfortunately, you will not be able to get that. However, im irabhu perosav kamohu. If let's say you made an eruv so that you physically can go there, so then your fruits are just like you, and therefore it's mutter al haviyam, it's mutter to bring them. As we continue to mem amud aleph. Misha zimin etzloi oyechem. Let's say a person has guests that are coming, Rashi says, mi'ira acheres, from another city, and they're coming because there is an eruv. So yoliho biyadam manos, you cannot bring manos, which we had that word before, referring to, are you allowed to give gifts? So you're not allowed to bring and allow them to take these manos, these leftovers. El inkin zachlahem minosehem erev yomtiv, unless they were already designated and you transferred ownership to them from before yomtiv. Okay. Itmar. So we learn the following. This is going to be question one. Hamafkin peros etzel chavero karagli mi moylichan oiso. So it says like this. Hamafkin peros etzel chavero. Let's say you gave your fruits as a safekeeping, that they're watching them for you. What is the din? Do those fruits belong to you because they're still yours? Or do we say, since this person is the one watching them, that the din is that it goes by that individual? So we have a machlokas. Rabbi Omer karagle mishef kidolo, and Shmuel Omer karagle hamafkid. So it's a machlokas whether, again, it belongs to the one who deposited it or the one who you deposited it to. So lema Rabbi Shmuel, perhaps this machlokas, the adul tamayhu, they go according to their reasoning. It says as follows in Baba Kama, Titnan. Im hichnis bereshus bal chayv, says Rashi. If let's say a person brought into the reshus his ox, the kedarosav of kedarosav peirosav v'chatzer chavero, so you brought these items which are yours into your friend's courtyard, so bal chatzer chayv b'nezikin. So because that person is taking upon themselves, according to this opinion, to watch these animals or these items, if anything happens to them, they are going to be responsible for them. Rebbe omel om enochayev ad shikabu labal habayis lishmar. Unless this person accepted responsibility, the fact that you just put them in this person's chatzar doesn't mean anything, and therefore if something happens to them, we do not say that they're chayev in the zikin. Yom rav hunam rav halacha kidibi chachamim. So Rav says the halacha is like the chachamim, which means, as we said, that a person is responsible for them. And Shmuel Omer halacha k'Rebbe, and Shmuel holds like Rebbe, that in fact this person, the Baal Chatzar, is not chayev. So lema Rav Yomer k'Rabban, and Shmuel Yomer k'Rebbe. So the very fact that we find that Shmuel says the halacha is like Rebbe, probably because that he holds like that, and it's the same situation as if you gave your fruits to someone to watch, whether or not those fruits are considered like in this person's domain. So if it's considered like they're by the person you gave it to, so that's similar to putting your items in your friend's chatzar, and now all of a sudden they're chayv acharayis. So Amalek Rav, on the Diyar Mefil L'Rebbe, I don't have to pigeonhole myself to this particular sheet. I can hold even like Rebbe, because I'd kind of look at Rebbe Hossam. The only time Rebbe said the din over there in Bava Kamma, again, Rebbe said that you're not going to be chayv until you are chayvach until this person accepts responsibility, is el de mastam ulkabel, because just stam, we don't assume that this person is going to be mekam lachrayis. Mastam ulkabel lehan netirusa. He's not there to accept responsibility to guard it. You say, okay, fine. You want to come in, you can bring it in. Abul hacha, but our mishnah hakabel lehan netirusa. This person, since he deposited his peros, so it's now in his rishus, and it's under his control, and therefore he must be the one that watches it. So therefore, it's based on the one that is shemaf kidulo. Shmo amr ana di amri afilu rabbanim. I can actually say the other way. Ad kan lo kamer rabbanim hasam. The only time that the rabbanim said over there that as soon as you give it, it's considered like that person has to watch it, and the person's chay b'achrayis. El dinich leila inish. The nikim turi brishusti de balchatzer, because it's good for this person that he's depositing, giving his shore to the domain of the balchatzer. So certainly he's going to want this person to watch this animal, and therefore you have nothing to lose. In fact, something happens to it, that other person's chayiv. The im mazik lei lo mechayiv. So we say, if let's say this thing was damaged. So according to the sheet of the Rabbanan, you're not going to be chayev. That's what we quoted. That we said that if you put your items into there, so the Baal Chatzer is chayev. Abul Hacha min yichle inish delekum peri b'shusi dechavre. Is it really a good thing that a person should put their fruits in the domain of his friends? Certainly not, because when you put your items into this other person's rishos, and if it's considered to be like now the person who's holding these peros, it's ki'ilu, like it's theirs, and therefore the eruv is based on them, so then I, the owner of those fruits, won't be able to have the same access to them. So in that situation, I don't want my fruits by you. However, when it comes to this animal, so you do want to say it's given over to that person. Fine. It's not. We learned in our Mishnah, Be'im, Erev, if a person did make an Erev, who, Peroys of Kamohu, and therefore, even though he's in a different city, he can go and get those fruits. Now, Be'yamrit, Karagamishev, Kidu Etzlo, if you want to tell me that it's totally on the person that's holding those fruits, so Ki'arvu, my hobby, that shouldn't help, because now it's in someone else's, in another person's domain, and therefore it should be totally on them. Our Mishnah is, for example, Shiachlu Keren Zabis, that you specifically put it in a corner. And therefore, because you designated a specific place, as Rashi, Hilchach Bershos Hamafkidhein. In that situation, it is in the domain of the Mafkid, which again is the person who deposited it. Okay. So it's being specifically. Well, Rashi is Abul Hacha. However, in a situation where the person accepts it and takes responsibility over it, that's considered to be like it's under his domain. So therefore, again, the machlokas, question one is, it's a machlokas karagli hamafkid or karagli meshifki dul etzlo. However, if you're miyachlo, karen zavius, kolyami, Lopligi karagli hamafkin. That goes based on the person who, whose the fruits are, because it's being specifically designated to a particular place. Tashma. Mishnah said, Mishnah ziman etzlo orachem. If they have guests, lo yolicha biyada manos. You can't give them the leftovers. Elimkin zochlehem minoisehin ne'erev yomtiv. Unless you already transferred ownership to them before yomtiv. Now, v'yamrit karagla mishef kidu etzlo, that we say that the fruit is like it belongs to the person, the other person, the one who's watching it, kizach lehem al yedei acher mayhavi. The fact that you're zeichet doesn't help because it's in your rishus. So, achinam, kivan shezach lehem al yedei acher, since you designated it to them already by transferring the ownership, kimi shiachlu keren zavistam. It's like you specifically put into a corner, and therefore you're saying, this is not really for me, it's their fruit, and therefore I'm finding the special place, or this leftovers, and therefore it's theirs, therefore they have the right to take it back. V'boy seyma zacha shani. Or you can say zacha is different, says Rashi. Shari kol atzmo The reason why he did this was so that it's not under his shvisa. The reason why you caused this transfer of ownership that they should be soichet is so that they will be able to bring it home. So in that situation, it certainly is an exception that in that case they would be able to bring it home, and it actually works. Rav Chana bar Chaniloi tola bistra ba'avra didish. So we find this Rav Chana bar Chaniloi, he hung meat by the bolt of a door. Also kamei de Rav Huna. Amalei said iat talisa. If you're the one that hung this meat there zil shok, then you can go and take it. The inhu talulach loy tishko, but if someone else did it, then you're not allowed to take it. Then you're not allowed to. Now we have to understand why. The ihu tala, if let's see, we said if he's the one that hung it himself, mishako. We said who would take it? Baho Rav Huna Talmud the Rav Havi Yomer Rav Karaglu Mishav Kido Etzloy. But he said that the din is it doesn't go after you; it goes after the person you put it to. So it shouldn't work. So Shani Abadidish, the Kamishiach Lo Kiren Zav is Dami, similar to what we said before, that since you put it on a specific place, it's also considered like it was designated for a particular place, and therefore goes to that person. Omele Rav Hillel Rav Ashi, Uvi Inhu Tolule Lo Shokol. So he said that he doesn't hang it if he was the one that, Vi Inhu Tolule, Loy Shakel. He says, if he's the one that hung it, then you don't. Av Yomer Shmuel Shor Shel Petim Harihu Karagli Shel Adam. We said that when you fatten up an ox, it has the din of Karagli Shel Adam, which means that even if they hung up the meat, it should still work, and you should still be able to take it, because when it came to the Shor Shel Petim, the person is fattening up for the sake of selling it, and therefore his das is on everyone. So if you're saying that if he is the one that did it, lo shakel. So Rav Ashi, Rav Kahana, the inhu talule lo shakel, but non habe behemakim hakilayim ba'kelim kiragli habalim. We say it belongs to the owner. El shani Rav Kahana. So we have all these difficulties. And therefore, we have to say like this. The story of over here is with Rav Chana bar Chaniloi. The Gavra Rabbah, who he was a great Talmud Chacham, he was someone that was constantly engaged in learning. And Rashi says, the time of Lami Shem Tchumim has nothing to do with Tchum Shabbos. So what is this whole idea? Because he was Vitori B'Shmaisa, because he was always engaged in his learning, Bacha Kamerlei. Ni at Masachta Deitecha V'lo Tishko. That if it was that if they're the ones that hung on it, so you're going to be so busy in your learning that you didn't have das on it, says Rashi. Rav Huna de'ori le'hoch le'talmidei Rav Havi v'Rav Omer v'shechitas chulin basar kivon shenistalam in ayin. So this is actually, interestingly enough, Rashi tells us this whole point is if you have meat that is away from your eyesight, you do not, and there's no tzvias ayin, there's no simen on the meat, and you distance away from it, us, you're not allowed to eat that meat. They feel totally biyateid b'beis Yisrael, even if you hung it on a peg in a Jewish home. Rav Chana agav tirda de shmaisa, because of his involvement, mishkach shar eiskav, he forgets about all of his other matters. So what he's basically saying, says Rashi, be atalis, if you hung it, midi de ovid inish biyadi, if you're the one that hung it up, then you're not going to have forgotten about it because you're the one that did it. But if someone else did it, it's not going to be in your mind. The people that hung it up are not going to really care about which is yours. And therefore, if you ask who that tayu, you'll end up diverting your attention. And in that case, you should not take it. So that's the idea. The reason is nothing to do with Eruv Tumim. It has to do with Basar Shnis Delam and Ayin. That you have to make sure that the meat is constantly being watched by a Jew, or else you're not to eat that meat. So if he's the one that hung it up, so then he'll have Das on it. But if not, then he may have forgotten about it because of all his learning, and then because of that, he would have to not be allowed to eat it. Okay. Fine. Let's see the last Mishnah. In Mashkin Meshaychtin Es HaMidborios, a person is not allowed to water or Shecht Midborios, which are going to say, we're going to see are like animals that are more removed from your home. They're like in the wilderness. And Rashi says because it's an issue of Muksa. And the Gemara is going to explain why it uses the word of Mashkin. Avo Mashkin Meshaychtin Es HaBaitos. You could Shecht. These animals, as we're going to see, are more domesticated, are more nearby your property. Elhein baitos, halonos be'ir, those that are basically in the city. Midbarios, these wild animals, halonos be'afar, that they are in the pasture, which means they're distant from you, and therefore they're out of sight, out of mind, therefore it's moksa. So, why does it mention watering? So, milsa gaborcha kamash, will come and tell you something along the way. The proper process is you should first water the animals, get them a little bit wet, then shech them, because it's otherwise the meat or the skin is going to get very sticky. There'll be stickiness of the hide. So therefore, if you water it first, it will make the skinning process easier. Tanrabanan. Elhin midbarios. Elhin baitos. Midbarios. Kol shiyotzes mipesach. If these animals, which are again are more in the wild, they go out in the springtime, brois be'afar, and again they are in the pasture, in the fields. The nechnasos b'revi shaina. They do come out during the first revia, the first like rainfall, which Rashi says in Mar Cheshvan, so they're away for a long time. Velhin baisos. These animals, which are more domesticated, are more closer to your city, closer to you. They do go out, but they only go outside of the chum. Or they do constantly come back within the chum. Rabbi Omer el v'il baisos. Even when it comes to an animal like the first example, those are still considered to be baitos, even though they're away for a significant amount of time. Elohim baisos ain. El Elhin Midbarios, Kol Shiyotzos Veroos Beofer. If you have these animals that are in the pasture of Enech Nasos Lishav, Lobi Mosacham Levos and Vishamim, they're not around basically ever. So those are the animals that are so far out of your mind that the din is their Muksa. Practically, Mi Yisle Lerebi Muksa. Is it true that Rebbe holds the din of Muksa when it comes to animals? Babamine Rab Shimon Bar Rebbe Merebi. He asked a question. When it comes to the Petzile Tamara, when it comes to these like peelings of dates, says Rashi, Tamarim She'en Mizbashleis, they're not ripened on the tree. So therefore, because of that, a person, again, doesn't really have much das on those things. Rav Shimon Ma, what's the din? Says Rashi, L'echle Mehen B'yamta. Does Rav Shimon allow you to eat these unripened dates on Yom, because again, the person really distanced themselves because they're not ready. So on this, Armalei ain muksil Rav Shimon. So he says that there's no din of muksa according to him, as we continue Mem and Mibes. El agroigris of smukin bilvad. The only time Rav Shimon, and even though we did see a couple of times on this Masechta, that Rav Shimon does hold a muksa under certain circumstances. But it includes Groigers of Smukin. What it has to do with these dried figs and grapes is Rashi Shehin Mitchila, originally Ruin Lachila. They're fit to be eaten. This week, again, we're on Mem and Beis, top Rashi. And then, Vahu Doichleisim Yadayim, you basically push them off with your hands. Why? Lahaloisim, you bring them up to the top of your roof, Vayavshin, so that they should dry. And once that happens, in this middle process of its drying, b'shuv in a ruin, they're not fit to be eaten at sheivshu until they're dried. So therefore, when it comes to those things, a person who biadayim has designated, I'm not going to use them, that's when Rav Shimon holds a muksa. Avol elu l'doch leis miadayim. When it comes to these cases, he did not push them off. V'ika d'achla minayhu. There are those who eat from it. Hachika salka daita, the metaphorish le milsa, Rav Shimon, alma Rav Shimon sirilei. The fact that he quotes Rav Shimon must be who holds like Rav Shimon. He does not hold a muksa. So therefore, how could we say that Rebbe holds this whole notion of muksa regarding these animals? Rebbe holds, apparently, like Rav Shimon. So Gemara gives, as we'll conclude this mesechta, with a few answers. Ibois ema haninami kigroigus smukindami. These animals are just like these fruits that are completely pushed off. Why? Why is that the same? Rashi says, Hainimid barus she'ein nechnasus leisha klal. They never come around. It's kigroigus smukindami. Shemakatsa oisin. You basically push them away from your hands. Like you have no distance. You've completely removed them away from you because they have no connection to them whatsoever. It's possible that he's just quoting Rav Shimon. It doesn't mean he actually holds like Rav Shimon. He knows Rebbe holds a muksa. But according to Rav Shimon, he's trying to explain the pshat of Rav Shimon. And then third possibility, in other words, like this, Ladidi, according to me, ain muksa. I don't hold in this issue of muksa. And therefore, it's not a problem at all, any of these animals. Eladidhu, however, according to you, that does hold a muksa, Oilimias, you should at least agree, Hechad the Yitzis, Rois, Vepasach, Nechnasis, Meraviri Shaina, Debaisos Hain, that when the animals go out for such a long period of time, all the way from the spring, and they don't come back until Cheshman, that those animals are considered to be Baitos, that we should say, that those animals, at least at that point now, are bisos, and therefore one is allowed to eat from them because they're considered like domesticated, because at least they do come back. The Amrul Rabbanan lo midbarius hain. I hold that those are also midbarius, and therefore you're not allowed to eat those either. Let's see a couple of questions, and obviously we're going to stop because that's the end of the sechta. Question two: Ma nikra midbarius aliba de Rebbe, ma tzad havi muksa afil Rav Shimon. So, as we said, according to the Sheet of Rebbe, he says, as long as they're grazing in the pasture, and they do not come, according to, that's the strict opinion, or really lenient opinion, he says that it's only, let's find this, Elhin Midbarios, is Koshiotis Ros Be'ofer Ve'en Nechnas Lishav Lobi Mosacham Lomosa Geshamim. So that's the only time, according to him, it's considered to be muksa. And the question is, Rav Shimon doesn't hold a muksa. So he says, no, it could be just like Gregor's Sesmukin. Why? So he says, Vasada havi muksa, the dummy Gregor's Sesmukin, shemakats to be a dime. That's considered like it's pushed off with your hands. We have one last question here. TA 15. Ma nikra midbarius alei de Rebbe, ma hasada havi muksa fil Rav Shimon. Exactly the same question. Kol shirois ba'ofer v'nechnas alisha v'lo me'osacham v'osacham v'shamim v'sad ha'havi muksa d'dam v'gregus v'smukin shemekatsa b'yadayim mamish, exactly the same. And with that we conclude the mesechta by saying ha'nulach mashilin peres v'slikala mesechtas be'ya. Adkan.